When at the opera with my wife, a time I'd soon forget. I'll peer into a telescope and not alone yet. I always store my forks and spoons inside my jacket pocket. And when I see a bumblebee, I make a point to mark it. For exercise, I run and place, although it may astound. Because I do so with my face laid firmly on the ground.
Hello, my good friends. I'm Throckmorton Fitz Spritzenkopf, but most people call me Fitz. And by most people, I mean the odd characters you will run into in this operatic rendition based on Edgar Allan Poe's story, Some Words with a Mummy. Mr. Poe notwithstanding, this is a comic opera, or rather, operetta. Two acts only, primarily in English. We'll have you out of here in no time. No waiting 4 or 5 hours for the fat lady to sing here. You can get a first look at me and the gang by going to mummy.richarddacosta.com. However, if you want to see more of me and my lovely bride, Rosalita, and a somewhat rowdy mummy, you and many of your ilk will need to lend a hand, if you can. Composer Richard DaCosta and librettist Thomas Cleveland Lane have worked up an amazing treatment of this story. On top of that, they've made the bold decision to present it as an animated feature, in addition to the staged operetta. That may be all well and good, but animation does not come as cheaply as you may think it does. There are considerable costs associated with the process. The last time DaCosta and Lane rolled through their Scrooge McDuck money vaults, all they found were dust bunnies and angry spiders. Here's where you come in to save the day! If you want to be numbered among the patrons of the arts, you can go to patreon.com/mummyopera. Then spend like a drunken sailor! Or, even better, a sober congressman. Seriously, any gift that will enable me and my colleagues to survive and continue to perform for you will be deeply appreciated. If you would be so kind as to help us along, there are some ways we would be happy to show our gratitude. If you've come this far and are still smiling and nodding your head, then let me thank you, raise a glass, and say to you in the ancestry or quasi-ancestry of my creators, Chentani. You don't necessarily have to be named Annie to contribute. Why? Because this is America,